Thank you. morning. I want to welcome everyone to the new Mount Sinai 22nd Annual Memorial Service. My name is Neil Hanlon. I have the honor and privilege of being president of the new Mount Sinai Board of Trustees. The cemetery was founded in 1850 and the oldest existing Jewish cemetery in the St. Louis area. In 1969, we opened this community mausoleum, which provides a final resting place that can be visited without concern for weather or season. In 2005, we were recognized for our outstanding architecture and historical significance by being named to the National Register of Historic Places. New Mount Sinai was the final resting place. Participants in every war the United States has been in since the Spanish-American War, as well as many of the city's distinguished luminaries, ranging from the worlds of government, business, philanthropy, and the arts. We offer burial for the interfaith families, as well as being the only Jewish cemetery to allow cremation when desired. We gather here today to remember our loved ones who have been put to rest in this beautiful cemetery. We especially want to remember those who we lost the past year, including two new Mount Sinai board members, Robert Bedmeyer and Shirley Schwartz, who were taken from us the last few months. May their memories be a blessing. I want to thank Cantor Seth Warner for his beautiful service, along with Cantorial Soloist Lynn Blumenthal, and our St. Louis Symphony members, pianist Vera, Parkin, and violinist Silvian, Iticovici. I also want to thank the Robert Lowenstein family for the chauffeur part of our service. On behalf of my wife, Natalie, our board of trustees, our executive director, Don Meister, and our entire staff, we want to wish you a happy and healthy new year.
Thank you, Neil. Good morning.
Good morning.
We spend the next few moments today in a bit of time suspended. We remember, we hope, we dream, we recall, and we heal. We spend these next moments together open to the possibility of a new year, even with those whom we loved not by our side. We look forward to a year of growth for ourselves, for those we love, and most of all, for the memories that we hold, they will grow too. So this is a safe place for our emotions to open. This is a safe place for our minds to wander through melody and words, through song, through prayer. This is the place that we can reduce our stress and open our minds to the possibility of healing for this new year that we lie at the very beginning of. On page 4, we read together, as we do throughout the book. We listen together, we pray together. Mourning is the price we pay for having the courage to love others. Even in grief, we know that the wonder of the human life is too complex, is too magnificent to be memorialized only in endless pain. The gifts of spirit our loved ones gave us cannot be measured or weighed, nor can they be lost or even tarnished by time. Even in our darkest hours, we know that some of their light and their warmth will always be with us, bringing comfort and courage, and in the fullness of time. Amen. It is a fearful thing to love what death can touch. A fearful thing to love, hope, dream, to be, and oh, to lose. A thing for fools, this, and a holy thing to love. For your life has lived in me. Your laugh once lifted me. Your word was gift to me. To remember this brings a painful joy. 'Tis a human thing, love, a holy thing, to love what death has touched. The words of Hashkivenu on page 5 are often recited in the evening as we prepare to rest. We include it in this service as an homage to the rest that we hope and pray that we might receive with the gift of those who have come before us, and simultaneously ask that their rest, their eternal rest, be a rest of peace and a rest of influence on us.
Oh,
this time of year we are called to reflect, we are called to remember, we are called to repent, we are called to celebrate. What a busy, busy 10 days we have. And while the majority of our Yom Kippur that we will experience in just a few days will be centered around our repentance of sins, perhaps now is a good time to recall the things that we have done this year that are good. Maybe this recalling of our goodness can bring us closer, not just to healing and wholeness, but to realizing that yes, we have sinned, but yes, we also have done well. And so this reading that is not found in your pamphlet will precede the 23rd Psalm. This is a confession of good deeds. We have loved, we have blessed, we have grown, we have spoken positively. We have raised up, we have shown compassion, we have acted enthusiastically, we have been empathetic, we have cultivated truth. We have given good advice. We have respected, we have learned, we have forgiven, we have comforted, we have been creative, we have stirred, we have been spiritual activists, we have been just, we have longed for Israel, we have been merciful, we have given full effort, we have supported, we have contributed, and we have repaired. May these positive attributes of our year outweigh the negative of what may come and of what we believe we have done. For yes, we have sinned, but we have also done well. Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He guideth me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Thank you. As parents show compassion to their children, so do you show compassion to those who revere you. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so is your love unending for those who serve you. At this hour of sacred memory, we turn our thoughts to those who are bound to us by ties of love and sweet remembrance. In gratitude for all the blessings our loved ones have brought to us, our people Israel, and to all humanity, we dedicate ourselves anew to the sacred faith of which they lived and died. Let them be remembered for blessings. For our parents who gave us life, nurtured us, and cared for us, we seek blessing through projecting their love for us onto others. We remember when we see our own children grow.
We give thanks by keeping them in our hearts.
For our brothers and sisters who are our companions throughout our lives, we seek blessing through opening our hearts. We remember as we tell our stories of their love and devotion.
We give thanks by keeping them in our hearts.
For our spouse who shared a love as deep as our hearts, we seek blessing through allowing that love to continue. We remember the early beginnings of our love.
We give thanks by keeping them on our hearts.
For our friends who are with us in good times and bad, we seek blessing through extending the hand of friendship to others. We remember the joy they brought to our lives.
We give thanks.
For our children, the lights of our lives extinguished too soon, we seek blessing through our strength to carry on. We remember despite the pain and difficulty.
We give thanks by keeping them in our hearts.
O God, this hour revives in us memories of loved ones who are no more. What happiness we shared when they walked among us. What joy when loving and loved we lived our lives together.
Their memory is a blessing forever.
Months or years have passed, yet we feel near to them. Our hearts yearn for them. Though the bitter grief has softened, a duller pain remains. The place where they once stood is empty now forever. The links of life are broken, but the links of love and longing cannot break. We see them now with the eye of memory, their virtues grown larger, their faults forgiven. So does goodness live and weakness fade from sight. We remember them with gratitude and bless their names. We remember the men and women who but yesterday were a part of our congregations and community, to all who cared for us and labored for the well-being of our people and humanity, we pay tribute. May we prove worthy of carrying on the traditions of our people and faith, for the task is now ours. Still, it is next to impossible to do this alone. We need the loving truth of others to be well. Inevitably, when one is thrust into life, into crisis, into transformation, without notice or instruction, some come with us and are forever changed, while others watch as we are forced out to see. It is the power of love that enables those who come along, and in truth, a language of experience is unearthed that cannot be translated by those who stay behind. If you wish, you can set your services aside for a moment. The great Neo-Hasidic rabbi and musician Shlomo Carlebach was known for enhancing the face of Jewish tradition with his insight. And parenthetically, in full disclosure, Carlebach's reputation was tarnished posthumously with Me Too accusations. But despite this, his legacy of impact in the realm of Neo-Hasidism cannot be overlooked. When he met someone for the first time, it is said he would introduce himself cheerfully and say, "Ah yes, we met at Sinai." He would enter into a conversation with his new friend as if they had known each other for years, greeting them with open arms and the warmth of an old friend. Carlebach was, of course, referring to the concept that all Jews, past, present, and future, those born into Judaism and those who choose Judaism, are a part of a continuum of tradition that transcends all time. The Torah portion we read just before Rosh Hashanah, Nitzavim, in it Moses gives his last speech before he dies, and Jews cross the Jordan Valley into the Promised Land. We read in Deuteronomy, "You stand here today, all of you, before the Lord your God, your tribal heads, your elders, your officials, all the men of Israel, your children, your wives, even your stranger, from the woodchopper to the water drawer, to enter into the covenant of the Lord your God, which God is concluding with you this day, with its sanctions, that he may cherish you this day, his people, and you shall be his people, as he promised you, as he swore to Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. I make this promise with its sanctions, not with you alone, but with those who are standing here and with those who are not here with us this day," implying that future generations and past generations all stood together in that very place. While the mountain overlooking the Jordan Valley where the Israelites stood and Mount Sinai are different physical geographic places, we can see that this idea of we're all in this together is pretty important throughout our tradition. Today we come with opened hearts and open minds to this hallowed, beautiful mausoleum to acknowledge that continuum of time and that we are linked to those who have come before us and to those who will come after us. While we may sit with our loved ones today, using Carlebach's notion, we sit along those who come to mourn and those who we mourn. We sit alongside them in chairs that are filled with those we know and those we don't. In many ways, we are inextricably linked to those we loved, even in death, by the gifts of memory and influence. It is said that we humans are unique in that our ability for memory is unmatched in the animal world. Yes, we are creatures who, often to a fault, remember more than any other known animal. What an amazing blessing that is. One of my earliest memories as a child is resting on my dad's chest in the den of our house. The warm brown wood of the floor, the light on the wall that made for calming shadows. He had an Ames chair that he sat in the evening. He would pull me onto his chest and I would curl up and rest. Quietly hum Yiddish songs in my ear. The melodies aren't clear to me anymore. I remember it being so soft and containing more love than actual notes. I don't remember the songs, and interestingly, he didn't either when I asked them about him when I got older. Maybe they were songs he learned at Sinai. Those memories are shrouded in the filters of time. Only shards remain for me, cloudy with the difference between remembering and wanting to remember even more. Wanting more time in his arms as a child. Wanting more time in his arms now. I remember conversations that I've had with people that I've loved, my dad and others. And I've strangely attached the location to where those calls happened. Remembering them as I pass those places makes me wish I could call again. I've even gone so far as picking up my cell phone and starting to dial the number and remembering that they aren't there to answer the call on the other end. I'd love to show you those places on a map where the people that I loved and who loved me had an impact. And I'd love to see your map too. Our memories of the people who led us to this very moment are a part of the key ring of our own lives. And on it, those keys unlock the secrets of who we are. Memory is a beautiful thing. It allows us to go back in time and live again at Sinai or somewhere else between here and there. Memory is a hard thing. When we return to our daily tasks, we're often left feeling empty and alone. These memories are a part of who we are. They are the fabric of us. It is as if each memory, each moment that passes, is like a grain of sand, adding to the rock of our existence. Each grain unique, beautiful, and complete. Each grain joining to the ones around it to become somehow part of something strong and formidable. The grains over time meld into one another and are no longer individual, but their individual impact is unmistakable. In this week's Haftarah portion for Ha'azinu from the book of 2 Samuel, it says, God lives, blessed is my rock. Exalted be God, the rock who gives me victory. God is at the center of that rock we create with the grains of our memories, with the grains of love, despair, happiness, and hope. Maybe it's that center that we received at Sinai. We take this moment now to recall those who we loved. In a moment, I'll recite the names of those taken from us since last Yom Kippur. And I invite you to quietly add the names of those who you remember, recalling them, recalling their impact, recalling their love. We remember Geraldine Alina, Karen Alina, Bruce Ballback, Jaquette Bergman, Jeannie Bierman, Brian Blank, Ruth Block, Edmund Axel Blomquist, John Allen Blumenthal, Susan Charnas, Oscar Cullen, Ronna Croft, Elliot Glassman, Robert Feigenbaum, Isabel Finkelstein, Harvey Friedman, Jack Froelichstein, Sheila Glazer, Dorothy Gould, Dolores Heller, Maxine Heyman, Ralph Albert Hertzmark, Gay Hirsch, Nanette Holtzman, Susan Yeager, Barry Kays, Scott Allen Kessler, Stanford Clearman, Alan Cohn, Robert Levine, Rita Levis, Jerome Levy, Stanley I. Levy, Danielle Lowe, Louise Mandel, Ben Phillips Monheimer Jr., Ken Marshall, Sydney Martin, Jeanette Meyer, Robert Bud Meyer, Vivian Meyer, Alva Moog Jr., Gloria Portnoy, Melvin Rabushka, Raymond Robinson, Gerald Rosenblum, Robert Paul Rothenberg, Elizabeth Ruich, Noreen Schumann, Shirley Schwartz, Edwin Schifrin, Harry M. Siegfried, Arthur Silver, Mary Silverman, Michael Joseph Steinbaum, Sherman Stiffelman, Paul Taxman, David Thompson, Cynthia Tomasi, Sanford Unger, Lilo Waxman, Karen Weisberg, and Richard Lewis Galen. To their names we add the names of all of those we remember, we loved in our hearts. We look to that place in our hearts where they touched us. We now recall them in reverence and in silence. If you are able, would you please rise?
Serora chayim et nishmatam shalom al mishkavam, v'nomar amen.
God, full of compassion, eternal spirit of the universe, grant perfect rest to those of our loved ones who have entered eternity. Source of mercy, let them find refuge forever in the shadow of your wings, and let their souls be bound up in the bond of eternal life. The eternal God is their inheritance. May they rest in peace. Let us say,
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
page 9. May the knowledge of your nearness be our strength, O God, for you are with us at all times, in joy and in sorrow, in light and in darkness, in life and in death. Cherishing the memory of our loved ones, we sanctify your name with the words of the Kaddish. Again, if you're able, please rise. Yit gadol v'yit gadash shemei rabah, ve'alama divrach rute v'yamlich malchute, v'chayachon v'yomachon v'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, v'ahagala v'yizman kariv v'nimru. Amen. Yehei shemei rabah mevarach le'olam v'lehome homaya. Yit varach v'yishtabach v'yit pahar v'yit romam v'yit nasei, V'yit hadar, v'yit ale, v'yit halal, shemei yekudsha barichu. Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tushbechata v'nechemata, da'amiran be'alama v'imru. Amen. Yehei shalama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. V'imru. Amen. Ose shalom b'romav, huya ase shalom. Aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, v'nimru. Amen. May the memory of the righteous always be a blessing. As together again we say, Amen. Chatima Tova, may you be written in the book of life for good, as we say together,
Amen.
Shana Tova.
Every day.
once there's peace.
I don't know.
I'm never going to go.
I don't know.
We'll be waiting a while. Depends on what your definition of peace is. I hope you'll have, I overheard you're traveling there, I hope you'll have the same experience that a lot of people have, that they feel safer in Israel than they do here.
Yeah. A lot of people walking around, we have a lot of people walking around and it's out of right.
There is a general feeling of sort of peacefulness where you are. Now, you'll see sort of armaments, but, you know, I walked around downtown Jerusalem recently, middle of the night, never felt safe. I didn't feel safe walking home at 9 o'clock at night from the ballpark to my car with my 11-year-old, right?
I can understand that. You're absolutely
It's a different level of fabulous trip. Linda, I'm going to run. I left your notebook.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, yes, he is. And his wife is doing fine. Yeah, they live in Baldwin. And it's a great place for children. Once the school district there is excellent. They've got six foster children and